New Mexico's pandemic response leaders this week backed off the timeline for vaccination, saying it will likely take months to get everyone who is older or has an underlying condition to get their two shots. Months. Even as President Biden promised more vaccine for the country, local rollout has hit stumbling block after stumbling block. The governor has been a cheerleader for distancing and masking and hand washing, as you know. Let's take another look back at the state of the state and see what she had to say.
The leadership our state has shown in fighting COVID-19 is the exact same leadership that will get us back on track. New Mexico was the first state in the country to establish a drive-through testing site. We have remained steadily in the top 10 nationally for COVID testing per capita. We mobilized a tribal response and assistance plan that was a model for other states. We're using cutting-edge science to test wastewater samples to prevent outbreaks at correctional and juvenile justice facilities. We will continue to rapidly, safely, and equitably distribute vaccines to every corner of our state. We told the truth about the pandemic, even when it wasn't what some of us wanted to hear. We protected our hospitals and healthcare resources. We got more than 26 million meals to school kids all across New Mexico. Doctors, nurses, caregivers, first responders, daycare workers, grocery store workers, correctional officers, and so many more have all shown up for their state with courage, dedication, and grace. We stepped up, all of us, as New Mexicans who love our state and look out for our neighbors.
Hey guys, on one hand, numbers are back down and the feared holiday spike wasn't huge, thank goodness. On the other hand, we have line jumping to get vaccines, a significant number of people who still feel masks are either unhelpful or are infringing on their personal freedom. Justine, are we really doing the neighborly thing here?
Is the governor doing the neighborly thing?
Yeah, and through extension, people, all of us.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think people are really doing their best for the most part. And with one major caveat, I would say that I think the administration has handled a very difficult, complex problem with lots of logistical nuances very well. The treatment of incarcerated populations and the disregard for people who are in custody, and not more than disregard, actually housing sex offenders together in a leper colony of COVID. I mean, I could go on. That to me is the exception. But in general, I think the administration has done well communicating, dealing with all these bureaucracies, getting the vaccine in, dealing with distribution, dealing with all these pharmacies and all the red tape, mm-hmm. and difficulties of a two-shot vaccine. And so I commend them for that. And you know, the public is just trying their best to keep going. I've said before, I think, you know, community leaders in some cases can do a better job of modeling, you know, safe behavior. And I mean, that's always true, but yeah, people are trying to muddle through.
Yeah, that's a good point. Senator Feldman, what are you seeing out there? Concerning logistics, local logistics, what concerns you?
Well, I think that New Mexico is doing a good job. Mm-hmm. We're the third best in terms of getting shots into arms. And just this past week, we vaccinated, I think it was something like 64,000 people. That's pretty fast. Having said that, though, I think there needs to be a better job done with communications in terms of explaining exactly these phases, 1A, 1B. Right. It's a particularly frustrating time now because we're in 1B, and of course, as we discussed earlier, there are some healthcare workers even that didn't take the vaccination in 1A, mm-hmm. and so now they're seeing that it works and it's fine, so they're coming on. And 1B, you know, which is people over 75 and people over 16 who have underlying health issues. That's a big group in New Mexico. One of our big problems in New Mexico is the incidence of chronic diseases like asthma, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, diabetes. And so that phase 1B is going to take a lot longer than expected. And that frustrates, for example, teachers and other essential workers. Mm-hmm. So that needs to be communicated better. I don't think there's a whole lot of line cutting. I think people are being respectful, and the state is being as nimble as it can be, given the fact that these vaccines have to be refrigerated. There are two doses. There are all kinds of logistical hurdles.
Mm-hmm. You know, we're talking about 700,000 to 800,000 people in that category you just sort of rattled off there, just to get, let folks know this is a huge challenge. Daniel, interesting point here. The Biden team says they found a mess in terms of vaccine delivery. You know, no surprise there. When you look at the federal government in their partnership on this, what's your sense of how they're doing? Is it transparent enough? Are they being fair to the states enough? Are they letting the public know what to expect enough? What's your gut telling you?
I think there's zero confidence from the average American in state, local, or federal government when it comes to dealing with this pandemic. I think, I agree with Justine. I think the governor's done as good of a job as she can do with the information that she has, but I think they're not going to be judged per se on the deaths. I think they're going to be judged on how they handled the dissemination of information. And I just think it's been from the top down, the bottom up, it's just been completely confused. I mean, just listening to Didi, the 1A and the 1B and the, my brain was shutting down. I can't imagine what the average person out there. I just know that, you know, we hear about how easy it is to get a test. I had COVID. My son had COVID. We had to get the family tested. You know, we had, you know, my wife signed up for a test, got a rapid test, found out later that day. The same day my daughter and I went to get tested, and it took 4 days for us to get an answer. You know, I know that we've had people in my family try to get in to get a test, and it's taken a week. Other people in my family have taken 5 minutes. I mean, literally. So I think what we've witnessed here is, listening to the former mayor and Obama chief of staff, who says never let a crisis go to waste. Mm-hmm. I think that this whole situation has been politicized from the start by everybody. I'm not blaming Democrats only, by everybody. But I think the average New Mexican is just, they're overwhelmed. It would be interesting. I was amazed, because I would have thought early on when they ran that poll that 70% of the New Mexicans were supporting the governor handling of the pandemic, that mm-hmm. the Journal poll. It'd be interesting to see what that number is today. I would think that number is going to be, there's going to be a massive movement, I would think, from that 70% number. And I think that's why, you know, mm-hmm. getting all this information out about here's what we're doing. I think they know that that number's moved. And that's why there's a lot of talk about addressing COVID, handling COVID, getting out shots, getting people back to school. Mm-hmm. That's why the center.
Good point there. Hey, Eric, Senator Grego, sorry, I know you know the name Tim Manning. He used to run our Homeland Security Department here under Governor Richardson. He is now in charge of supply line strategy for the president. It's very, very interesting. Are we going to get an inside track here? Are we going to get a little something from having a New Mexican in that place? I mean, I'm sort of half joking. We have a direct line into the administration. What's your sense of that?
Well, I think that was the consolation prize for the governor not getting in the cabinet. I think she did a good job of, like, I think trying to get some good New Mexicans into the mm-hmm. into the administration. Hopefully that'll benefit us. You know, I just want to just add to something that Dan said in your question. You know, I think this is like a textbook failure of an important role for the federal government that happened. You know, to say that Biden should turn on a dime and have this strategy and solve all these problems when there was no strategy. And it was, you know, this is going to be taught in political science classes for the next generation about the utter failure of our, mm-hmm. of our federalist system. The federal government just absolutely, you know, being neglected of their role. So I actually agree with everyone who said that the governor and the state has done a pretty good job of, and I had a different experience than you, Dan. I mean, I got on the site. I'm not eligible yet for a shot for a vaccine. I had testing done a couple of times. It was quick. It was drive through. It was very, very precise. And so I feel like we're doing as good a job as we could, considering the neglect from having a federal strategy and something as important as this. So hopefully, not just Manning, but other folks who are in these important positions will demonstrate how important it is to have competent people mm-hmm. in our federal government. It really is important to not just beat up on them, but actually to have people who can get the job done when you have something as important as a crisis like this.
I appreciate you elevating that point to that place. Really appreciate that. Now, we're back in a moment to talk lawmakers availing themselves of pandemic aid, whether they voted for it or not.